Ever think you'd meet a milkman who'd try to sell you a non-dairy creamer?
No.
Well, you have now. Creamora from Borden. It's a non-dairy creamer with a richer, creamier aroma. Sniff the leading brand. Now sniff Creamora.
Creamora does smell creamier.
Now taste your coffee.
Has a delicious, creamy taste.
Creamora, a richer, creamier aroma in the jar, and you just can't beat its creamy taste.
I'm used to getting what I want, especially from my Allen Bush broker. I'm getting the most professional and personalized service I've ever had, and I appreciate their reduced commissions. What a savings. It takes action to get what you want today. All it takes is a step in the right direction. Good work, Allen Bush. Call Allen Bush and receive your reduced commission schedule brochure. Customer securities protected to $500,000 by SIPC.
All those creepy, crawling night creatures, those fiendish bugs, it was time they met their doom. So I gave it my best shot. Hot Shot. Hot Shot killed those roaches, ants, and other crawling things fast and easy. My house is peaceful now. Yours can be too. Just give it your best shot. Hot Shot.
Channel 12, your station for news. This is Channel 12 News, the 6 o'clock report with Eleanor Schano-White.
Good evening, everyone. Well, everything is go tonight at Cape Canaveral as the launch of the Space Shuttle Columbia nears liftoff. The two astronauts, John Young and Robert Crippen, well, they inspected the ship this morning and reported everything is in satisfactory condition. Excitement is reaching a peak at this hour. Throngs of tourists are gathering at the Cape in preparation for tomorrow morning's historic event. Now, reporter Stephanie Stahl and photographer Mike McInerney, well, they spent the whole day there today, and they're going to have a special report a bit later in this newscast. Meantime, a group of local lawyers are closing down jails in Palm Beach County. Stan Zimmerman reports the mere threat of a federal lawsuit closed one, and it's threatening to close another. Still, there is a third jail that may have to be replaced. And we'll have more on this story. Stan has been following the story of the jail problem here in Palm Beach County. As we said, three of them now, three, will be closed down in the near future. All right, in other news tonight, there are some new developments in the fate of two Florida death row inmates. A federal judge has stayed indefinitely the execution of David Leroy Washington until he hears evidence on Washington's charge that he received poor legal counsel. Meantime, the Florida Supreme Court moved triple murderer Gary Elden Alford one step closer to the electric chair. That's for the third time the court upheld his death penalty, scheduled to be carried out on May 6th. We'll have more news right after this.
This is a man who never liked to shop for clothes until he discovered our store and the Jacobson feeling. He found how good it was to have people who knew just what he wanted, clothes that made him feel good about himself. He discovered how complete this men's store was with everything that was just his style for everything he did. Comfortable, confident, always dressed just right. He has the Jacobson's feeling.
Lunch is served.
Let's eat.
These bite-sized cars.
Hi, your new car rust-proof?
Sure is. See? Took it to Z-Bart.
Oh, those Z-Bart technicians.
Trained to get into those tasty hidden places.
That lifetime warranty.
You guys could starve.
Hi, your new car rust-proofed?
Yep. Car dealer did it.
Bring your car to Z-Bart. No car dealer protects like Z-Bart.
Come here. They're eating the car. Help.
The arthritis medicine doctors recommend most is aspirin, but it can irritate stomachs. Today, there's a better aspirin, Ecotrin, specially coated aspirin to help prevent irritation. Plain or buffered aspirin dissolves in the stomach, but Ecotrin's aspirin is coated to go past your stomach before dissolving. For temporary relief of minor arthritis pain like these give, with less worry. Ecotrin. Great idea. Ecotrin, specially coated aspirin to help prevent irritation.
Public service organizations and charities do an awful lot for a lot of people, but they can only do that with a lot of help.
I'm Charlton Heston. I'd like your help supporting the American Red Cross and the American Film Institute. I'm hosting a pro-celebrity charity tennis classic at the Palm Beach Polo and Country Club at Wellington in South Florida, May 8th, 9th, and 10th. A lot of my friends and your favorite stars will be playing, along with top pros from all over the world. I hope you'll be there.
So tomorrow is the big day at Cape Canaveral. As we already reported, 12 News and Sky 12 will be on hand for the historic launching of the Space Shuttle Columbia. Now, Stephanie Stahl and photographer Mike McInerney spent the day there, and they have a special report now on the fever pitch that exists at Cocoa Beach tonight.
In less than an hour, this clock will begin the countdown for the historic launch of Columbia, the reusable spaceship. An estimated 1 million people will converge on the area surrounding Cape Canaveral to watch the liftoff. They've come from as far as California and Canada. Every hotel in Brevard County is booked, some charging three times the normal price. Portable toilets line the major highways for those who have taken to the streets.
Today, we can't find a room, so we're going to be out here early anyway, so we thought we'd come out and just stay.
It's just amazing, you know, what man's mind can do. I could never be capable of anything like that, and it really fills you full of wonder.
I think we really need the information they're going to obtain from this. And it has a lot of scientific benefits that a lot of people don't realize. I don't think, a lot of people think it costs a lot of money, but I understand it costs a lot less than a lot of other foolish things that we already do.
Yes, I hope the American people back it 100%. I think it's very important. And it just thrills me every time I see it.
The community surrounding the Cape is just as enthusiastic. Words of encouragement are everywhere. It's the first launch in nearly 6 years, providing the local area with a much-needed economic boost. Restaurants are packed, traffic jams have already started, and souvenirs are all over. Inside the Kennedy Space Center, 80,000 VIPs, including all the former astronauts, will get front row seats, 3 miles from the launch pad. That's where the news media en masse is headquartered also.
Hello and welcome to Cape Canaveral, where the news is.
T-minus 1 day to blastoff entails a series of press briefings like this one on the final preparations for the launch.
Fellow rocket boosters, we're going to what appears to be straight up. The tail is going to swing around to the east.
The interest and excitement centers around 75 tons of metal. The countdown is underway and all systems are go. But even a few clouds could delay the launch of $8 billion worth of space-age technology. Stephanie Stahl, 12 News at Cape Canaveral.
And for those of us who can't be there in person, just stay tuned to 12 News and we'll bring you all the excitement. Word tonight that a group of local lawyers are closing down jails here in Palm Beach County, and Stan Zimmerman is ready now with that report.
This is as close as we're allowed to come at the women's jail for Palm Beach County, a jail threatened with closure by a federal lawsuit.
And all the women that are housed in Palm Beach County are housed in the Lake Worth City Jail. There are not any women in the Palm Beach County Jail. We have this old, I say old, it's about a year old now, federal class action suit regarding the Palm Beach County Jail that houses only the men. The women's facility in Lake Worth is equally as bad, we feel, in terms of conditions, and we just want that jail also to meet the minimum constitutional requirements.
Another suit by St. John is responsible for shutting down this city jail in West Palm Beach. Last Monday, the city commission followed the advice of their attorney and agreed to close it down because it does not meet federal standards.
Well, when we kept our facility open after the municipal courts were phased out, we did so as an accommodation to these other agencies, the sheriff, the state, and the federal government, at their request. And when we were faced with liability in keeping a jail facility open, we decided that at this point in time, it's best to turn it over to those agencies, and if they want to run it, then they can run it at their risk and at their expense.
St. John uses a 90-year-old civil rights law and files on behalf of prisoners in the Lake Worth, West Palm Beach, and Palm Beach County jails. That law and subsequent federal court decisions have set minimum standards for prisoners awaiting trial.
Apparently, it's a pattern in Palm Beach County to close all the outlying jail facilities and return the inmates held there to the much more crowded and ill-equipped Palm Beach County Jail.
The root of the problem is this building, the Palm Beach County Jail. Old, obsolescent, due to be replaced within 2 years. It too is the subject of a federal lawsuit, but this one is being bitterly fought in the courts between St. John and Palm Beach County. A decision is expected within a month. Stan Zimmerman, 12 News, West Palm Beach.
Good news for a change. All is quiet tonight in the Loxahatchee area. Authorities report no new outbreaks of fire. Nearly 500 acres of brushland was burned during the past 2 days. Some residents left their homes as the flames closed in. Fortunately, no one was injured in the blaze. No homes were seriously damaged. Well, the dry weather conditions which affected the brushlands are also having an impact on Boca Raton. City's water demand is exceeding its supply. And as Doreen Marcial says, Boca's leaders are doing something about it.
As expected, Boca Raton residents will be required to follow a water schedule effective today.
The restrictions on heavy water use, and predominantly that means watering your yard, is that for the people whose house number or building number is an even number, an even street address, they are limited to turning on their sprinklers or taking the hose to the yard on the Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. If you live in a house where your street number is an odd number, then your days for watering are Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. The other days of the week, you're not to run your sprinklers.
Zumwalt adds the same applies for filling your swimming pool and washing your car. He says a revised version of penalties will be voted on by City Council next Tuesday. If passed, the maximum penalty will be getting your water turned off. But Zumwalt notes that it will be hard for the city code enforcement staff to enforce the rules. Zumwalt believes Boca residents are aware of the problem and will probably cooperate. And based on the reaction gathered by 12 News today, he may be right.
Well, since it is an emergency, I think we should cooperate and go along with it. Certainly, it's for our own good.
While I'm willing to cooperate, I just feel that I think, you know, the taxes that we pay the city ought to have prepared for this.
I'm for it 100%. I think it's a very good thing. We're short of water in this area, and I believe everyone should cooperate.
Zumwalt says how long the emergency will last depends on two things, water usage and the weather. He predicts it could be anywhere between 1 and 2 months, possibly even longer. Doreen Marcial, 12 News, Boca Raton.
Well, the school board wants to place new emphasis on increasing employees' salaries in the next fiscal year. Superintendent Tom Mills will recommend at the next school board meeting that salaries be the number one priority in budgeting for fiscal year 1982. Deputy Superintendent James Hall said teachers can't negotiate salaries next year due to a provision in their contract.
Well, they haven't been at the top, well, I guess it was 2 years ago. That they were. But this last year we had the bargaining agreement settled for a 2 year period, and they're just now opening up for bargaining again. Due to the considerable inflation that we've had, the board wants to see that we make every effort to do what we can with employee salaries.
Also high on the board's priority list is the addition of art, music, and physical education teachers. And Mills plans to recommend a special grant totaling $100,000 for seriously handicapped students. Patty Sherman is up next with the weekend forecast when 12 News continues.
It gave me a net worth of $250,000 in less than 8 months.
Using that formula, I've bought about $1 million worth of property since that time.
My goal was 5 houses in 5 years, and now in 2 years' time, I already have 10 houses.
Checked a Robert Allen Nothing Down seminar with no real estate background at all to speak of, and since then, I've bought quite a bit.
Don't miss the free Nothing Down 90-minute How to Do It seminar. Learn how to make it when you're cash poor from famous millionaire authors Robert Allen and Hollis Norton. You can start on the road to financial security by attending the free Nothing Down seminar given by the author's personal representative. No cost, no obligation, starting at 8 p.m.
Thursday night, April 9th, at the Palm Beach Gardens Holiday Inn, PGA Boulevard at I-95, Turnpike Exit 44 in Palm Beach Gardens. This is your last opportunity to attend this free seminar. For further details, see the Nothing Down ad in West Palm Beach newspapers.
Byron Furniture in Delray Beach invite you to save on fine home furnishings by Century, Henrietta, and other name brands. Right now, at the start of the season, we've included luxurious living rooms that reflect your lifestyle, handsome dining rooms, and beautiful bedrooms, with spectacular savings for a limited time only. And for a look that you'll love to live with, complimentary design service. The Century and Henrietta Sale at Byron Furniture, 2000 North Federal Highway, Delray Beach.
Did you get the post this morning? If you did, you know how the stock market's doing and how the world's doing. Post editorials and features gave you insight into the news, business, science. Won a Pulitzer a few years ago. Great sports coverage, too, from the big leagues right down to our local kids. This morning, every morning, the Post brings you news you can't afford to miss. Subscribe now.
Those of you who are watching the evening news right now are part of a growing number of Americans who receive most of their information from nightly TV newscasts. Fred Pierce, president of ABC Television, was in town today, and he talked to me about the trend as it's perceived at the network level.
Encouraged by the fact that we sense an upward momentum in some of the ABC news viewing levels, and last week, for example, the obvious interest in national news was indicative of the fact that viewers' interest in news in general is increasing.
You say we're going to see more national news in the future.
I think before not too long, we will see an expansion of evening news. Whether it occurs in the time frame that it's presently presented or it will in effect occur at a later hour of the evening is yet to be determined by marketplace influences.
Pierce, along with the presidents of NBC and CBS, addressed close to 1,000 members of the American Association of Advertising Agencies meeting this week at the Boca Raton Hotel. And Patty, I can tell you all of those folks, including Mr. Pierce, were mighty happy to be in town today. Weather was just beautiful and looking good for tomorrow, huh?
It's looking good for tomorrow for the launch, and I hope they're sticking around for the weekend because it looks terrific for the weekend.
Great.
So the winds have subsided, the temperatures are nice and warm, it's sunny outside, so it's perfect conditions here in South Florida. Our temperature right now is 77 degrees, relative humidity 60%. East-southeasterly winds, no gusts, just 14 miles an hour steady. Barometric pressure, 30.20 and steady. Surf temperature 72. And our range in temperatures, just a 10 degree climb from 70 to 80 today. No rainfall and the air quality was 33 in the good range. In the nation today, you'll see the cold front that's pushing into the east, and this was what was worrying forecasters for the launch. However, the clouds are pushing to the northeast and just skirting north of Florida and north of Georgia. Most of the heavy showers and clouds to the north of it into the mid-Atlantic coast states and started clouding up in New England. Fair skies behind it and some windy conditions persisting due to high pressure. Last night there were very heavy thunderstorms over portions of Missouri and Arkansas. 1-inch hail reported doing some damage in east central Missouri, and now the heavy thunderstorms have shifted to the east from Kentucky northward through Pennsylvania and New York, with light rain along the coast from Maine down into South Carolina. This frontal system should push offshore and cause no threat to our weather here in Florida. Cooler conditions or air is moving in behind the frontal system. This morning it was 20 degrees in Bismarck, North Dakota for the nation's low. The rain has let up in the Pacific Northwest, but they're having windy conditions. Wind advisories in effect for Washington State and still travelers advisories for the Cascades Mountains of northern Oregon. And now we'll check the afternoon temperatures from around the country.
We'll be right back.
clear skies around the state, and that's the way it'll look in Cocoa Beach tomorrow. We're expecting sunny temperatures climbed up into the 80s this afternoon over northern Florida, and pretty warm over the southern part of the state, too. The warmest right now, Fort Myers, with 86 degrees, and as we look outside, it's completely dry, and we're not showing too much by the way of rain in our forecast either, so let's take a look at it. Tonight, we're calling for partly cloudy weather, mild conditions, a 20% chance of showers, some light showers possibly moving onshore, easterly winds at 10, lows between 68, that should read inland, and 72 along the coast. And tomorrow, partly cloudy and mild, easterly winds at 15 miles an hour, and highs in the low to mid 80s. For boaters, small craft are advised to exercise caution until the winds and seas subside. The winds are out of the east at 15 knots. Seas will be coming down to 3 to 5 feet. Inland coastal waters, a moderate chop. So the boating conditions are improving. High tide at 12:31 this evening, low tide at 6:55 tomorrow morning, sunset at 6:41, sunrise at 6:02. And for the weekend, beautiful, partly cloudy and warm with lows in the 70s, highs in the 80s, just like today. So it should be perfect. Good beach weather.
And the way those folks are crowding into Cocoa Beach, I think they'll appreciate your mild temperatures tonight. Maybe some of them will have to be sleeping under the stars. Thanks, Patty. Jim Gallagher is back from North Carolina, where he received the Florida Sportscaster of the Year Award. And Dave Wirth talks with swimmer Stella Taylor about to attempt to cross Lake Okeechobee. All that and more when we return.
Right now, there's a grand opening sale so big, it's going on in every Zehr store everywhere. That means you'll find tremendous savings wherever you look. All men's golden Fruit of the Loom 3-packs in stock, 20% off. Every automatic coffee maker we have, 25% off. Big grand opening specials. Huge grand opening savings now through Saturday. Because at Zehr, you get more than the latest fashions. When you get to Zehr, you get it all.
Get to Zehr and get it all.
Remember your bouffant hairdo and all that stiff hairspray? Well, hairstyles changed a lot. Now hairsprays did too, like the soft hairspray called Rave. Look, spray Rave on one side, a stiff holding spray on the other. This spray dries so stiff the comb can barely get through. But you can comb through Rave without combing out the hold. Try Rave Soft Hairspray, the flexible hold you can comb through.
When there's nothing but mud where the road used to be, and you feel like your car is working overtime, it's nice to have this gas-saving Toyota pulling for you. Introducing the 1981 front-wheel drive Toyota Corolla Tercel. The Toyota Tercel. A car that pulls its own weight.
And a little bit more.
Oh, what a feeling!
Tercel!
More.
And at Gold Photo, we think you deserve more. We know how important your photos are to you, so we give you same-day service. In by 10, out by 5. Quality processing done on Kodak paper for a good look. And of course, our giant Big Shot 4-inch prints. So shop around, compare, then remember.
With the Gold Photo Big Shot, you get so much more.
The lady they call the swimming nun is jumping back into the water this weekend. Dave Wirth reports that the swim will be quite different. It's a 19-hour marathon, and it's going to be a little different for amazing Stella Taylor.
Marathon swimmer Stella Taylor is tackling Lake Okeechobee as part of the Black Gold Jubilee in Belleglade. She'll start from Moorhaven Saturday night at 9 and finish at Belleglade Sunday afternoon, a total of 31 miles. The 51-year-old former nun is thankful the freshwater lake isn't home to sharks or man-of-war, but there are other problems.
We have many, many alligators, and within half an hour period, somebody saw 17 alligators out there, and they weigh close to 300 pounds. They're very big ones, but I hope they're not going to be a threat, and I don't think they will be. And then there are the cottonmouth water moccasins, which, if I'm stung, I always figure it this way, it can't be any worse than man-of-war.
Stella won't be alone on the lake. Her ever-present crew will be in the water with her and in nearby boats. She's been unsuccessful in recent ocean swims, but is confident of this one. Then, possibly retirement?
I'll keep going, and I'm thinking of Channel Double, if I can get the sponsorship. Then, possibly Marathon Key to the Bahamas.
If all goes well, Stella will finish her Lake Okeechobee swim 5 o'clock Sunday afternoon at Torrey Island in Belglade. Stella, you all ready to go?
Oh, I'm very excited. I'm getting very psyched up now.
Good. Dave Wirth, 12 News in Belglade.
And we welcome our award-winning sportscaster. Third year in a row, Jim Gallagher voted Sportscaster of the Year in Florida, and you were up in North Carolina to receive your trophy or your nice plaque. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. It was very nice, and it's nice to be back. As a matter of fact, it's good to have work. The 45th Masters Golf Tournament got underway in historic Augusta National this morning in Georgia, and the cream of golf's crop teed it up in hopes of wearing the green jacket by sundown on Sunday. And as far as the scores are concerned this afternoon, Curtis Strange and Johnny Miller, who looks like he's back, in with 69s, tied for the early lead. A group bunched at 70, including Jack Nicklaus of Lost Tree Village, Jim Simons of DeCuesta Jumbo, Isayo Aoki of Japan, David Graham, who lives in Delray Beach, and Hubert Green of Tallahassee. They're all in at 70. In at 71, Tom Watson, Jerry Pate, Ben Crenshaw, and from Hollywood, Florida, Gibby Gilbert. Major League Baseball is underway for 1981, the season starting yesterday with the traditional opener in Cincinnati. The Braves and Expos conducted spring training in West Palm Beach this year, and both teams have a chance at their division championship. Montreal more so than Atlanta. The Expos went down to the last day before bowing to the eventual champion Phillies in a tight race for the Eastern Championship last year. And I talked to manager Dick Williams and asked him if I thought that the race would be that close again. And Dick thought that it would be close again because of the fact that all the teams in his division are improved.
Oh, absolutely. Nothing's ever easy. And I've never been around it when it's been easy. And I like our chances. I think we're a maturing club now compared to the last couple of years. We finally got our feet wet in close play going down to the last series each of the last 2 years. And we're still a young ball club where I think the Pittsburgh club and the Philadelphia club, they may be on a downgrade. They may have reached their peak, and they're mighty fine ball clubs too. But overall, the last 2 years, even though we haven't won anything, our one loss record is better than both of them.
Dick Williams, the manager of the Montreal Expos. As a matter of fact, Montreal a winner this afternoon as a former West Palm Beach Expo player, Gary Carter, was the hitting star. Montreal dumping Pittsburgh 6-5. The Mets over the Cubs by a 2-0 score. And in the American League, it was Detroit over Toronto 6-2. New York dumped Texas by a 10-3 score. And Oakland over the Twins by a score of 5-1. There are 8 playoff games in the National Hockey League tonight. Last night, the Rangers skated past Los Angeles. So the Rangers now have a 1-game lead after their 3-1 win last night over the Los Angeles Kings. And that's going to do it for sports.
Thank you, Jim. Beautiful sight at the Palm Beach Mall these days. We're going to show it to you in just a minute.
Tonight, you can see the perfect racing machine. Palm Beach Kennel Club. Tonight at 8.
Crime is increasing. Where will it stop? Stop crime at your door or window with Roll-Up, the real protector. Call Roll-Up now for fast installation and substantial savings. Enjoy solid security against intruders with Roll-Up, the real protector. Call Roll-Up now for a free estimate. You'll find Roll-Up under W in the white pages. Roll-Up, spelled W-R-O-L-U-P.
Lots of folks are into fitness nowadays, fitness that includes a healthy, nutritious diet. When you talk about nutrition, right here is the natural place to start. Dairy farmers provide an important part of a well-balanced diet, and at a price you can afford. It's fresh, delicious milk, Florida's fitness food. The milk we produce is taken every day to modern dairy facilities, where it's tested for content and quality under the most rigid standards of excellence. Then all this milk is sealed up for delivery, fresh to you. Every carton is packed with the natural nutrition you need to work your best and play your best. Milk just naturally fits into fitness. So to get into shape and stay fit, stay on a well-balanced diet and drink Florida's fitness food, fresh, cold milk.
A rose by any other name would smell as sweet, but if the price has anything to do with it, well, there's another flower that could be considered sweeter.
We don't give orchids much thought, but maybe we should. Here are some facts that might surprise you. They're one of the most expensive flowers in the world. The price usually depends on the color and the size. A top specimen could cost as much as $40. The flowers take at least 2 years to grow to maturity. The Tropical Orchid Society is having its 12th annual orchid show at the Palm Beach Mall until Saturday, and it's free. These expensive beauties are right out in the open. You can see them, smell them. No armed guards, no lock safe, just lots of beautiful, beautiful orchids. That's the early edition of 12 News. John Matthews will be here tonight at 11. ABC World News Tonight is next with more on tomorrow's launch of the Space Shuttle Columbia. I'm Eleanor Schano-White. Thank you for joining us and have a nice evening, everyone.
The next time you're hot to trot, horse around at Pompano Harness. Post time, 7:30.
At Pompano!
We're always hot to trot.